I'm Robert Timmons, and you're watching Weekly Words.
Yeah. Stop me. Stop me. Stop me. Once upon a time, the people pleaser in me would hold back. So God said this message is much bigger than rap. It's been happening for years, we've seen it across the map. The boomerang flow, me and Tom just brought it back. Preaching at people with no love. Stay looking at sinners with cold shrugs. The like-minded get met with warm hugs. Welcome to the circus, it's all good on the surface. If you don't agree, then throw a stone. All our house is made out of glass, I'm going home. Thinking, who's who, it's the attack of the clones. I'm at the final table when cards.
Thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Weekly Words. I hope you've been enjoying the series so far, and we're going to start off week 10 talking about something that I think is very deep and actually really pertains to my personal life. So today we're going to talk about the adversities of life and having to work through them, and the idea that we as humans start to put on this self-made armor to try to make ourselves bulletproof. But are we really making ourselves bulletproof? So let's get started. Growing up and navigating through my life thus far, I've always been told not to heavily complain about my adversities and my life circumstance, that I have to continually work to have the things that I want, that I have to work for my happiness, work for my success, and work for all these different things, that nobody wants to hear me always complain, that ultimately I'm the one responsible for my happiness. And to a degree, I do believe that you are responsible for the way that you carry yourself and how you allow things to impact you, right? If you just focus on the problem or if you work through to get to a solution. But I do also believe that there is a proper way to navigate through that adversity and an improper way, right? The proper way involves God, and the improper way involves us doing things completely on our own. All right, so let's dissect that a little bit. So the improper way for us to navigate through the adversities of life is us trying to put this armor on ourselves to protect ourselves and make us bulletproof so that adversity can't get in, right? So that we're just trying to just ignore those negative thoughts that people have to say and ignore the different insecurities that we have and the pain that we've experienced and how we've been mistreated by friends or significant others, our parents, our family members, or whatever the case is. We just want to put on this armor, protect ourselves from that so it doesn't happen again, right? And armor can, you know, be transcribed in so many different ways, right? Armor can be the way that you navigate through social media and you seeking to have constant, you know, likes and views and retweets on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, whatever the case is. Like it's this online persona of yourself where if you feel you get validated if so many people are interacting with you but not really interacting with you, right? It also can be your social status, you know, trying to say, you might have had whatever insecurities growing up, but now you want to flash your social status about, you know, what kind of job you have or how many friends you have or whatever the case may be. It can also be like your resume. A resume was designed for us to give to future employers about, so they can see, you know, what our experience is and what we bring to the table for this position that we're applying for. But there's people in the world who just flash their resume around trying to brag to everybody that they see. I've had multiple conversations with people that I've just met for the first time, and they're essentially reading off their resume to me as they were having a conversation, and it doesn't apply to the conversation at all, but they're validating themselves in reading off their resume to help hide some of those doubts and fears and insecurities. And also it can be lust, right? So you're never going to know someone more fully than when you're naked with that person and you're together, right? So there's this idea of lust that whether it's a subconscious thought or a conscious thought where being with somebody is validating for you, because no matter what, in that moment, they're accepting you. They are embracing you, right? But it all, you know, speaks to the further pain that we've experienced through life. And it also can be, armor can also be material things. So, you know, going after whatever car, whatever job, whatever amount of money, whatever house, all these different things are us trying to build our lives up and put these walls in front of us, this armor in front of us, right, to protect us from the pain and adversity. But really, it doesn't like protect us from the pain. It just conceals it, right? Like that pain on the inside, if it's not addressed, it's still going to be there. It's just blocked in. It's contained. And it actually becomes a burden because we're still living with that day by day, no matter how much money we have or how many friends we have or followers, our cars, our things, our sexual partners, or how much we have listed on our resume, that pain is still there. We have to address it, right? So this leads into the proper way of dealing through life's adversity and bringing God into the situation. So in Hebrews 12, verse 28 and 29, it talks about the kingdom of God being unshakable and all of the things in the kingdom of God being unshakable. And so we were created to be part of the kingdom of God. So we were created to be unshakable. But in order for us to stay in the kingdom of God, we actually have to surrender our lives to him, right? And it's a very detailed thing because we can't just say we surrender our life to God, but we have to surrender all those different areas. We have to surrender our insecurities, our doubts, our finances, our personal relationships, our professional relationships, right? Our fears, all these different things. We have to surrender to God and speak to him and tell him how we are unsure of our purpose, how we have fear of what people will think, and how we don't think we can live up to the standard our parents have for us. All these different insecurities and fears and doubts that we have to surrender that to God. We need to boast in our weakness to him so that he can show his strength, because yes, there are things in this world that are truly difficult and that we just realistically aren't able to do. But with God, we can, right? We just have to surrender to him. And the thing is also about this verse, Hebrews 12, verse 28 and 29, it talks about the kingdom being unshakable. It does not say anything about adversity not coming, hardship not coming, negativity not coming. It says that it's unshakable. Right? So even though you're unshakable, the kingdom of God being unshakable doesn't mean you're not going to have tests and trials that move you and try to stop you from going on your purpose. It's just saying that it's not going to affect you, but those trials are still going to come. Right? So don't lose hope whenever you surrender to God and there's still negativity happening around you, but no trust that you are unshakable if you are surrendering to God, right? It kind of goes back to what I talked about last week about life's construction, right? There is that time when you're working through it for the construction to come to pass. And the same thing goes here. We have to address the pain, insecurities, and doubt, surrender it to God to be able to overcome it. Because if we don't, it's just going to sit there. It's just going to sit there and not be addressed. And then one day it's all going to come out whenever the final piece of straw breaks the camel back, right? We have to address it and surrender to God so that we can step into the promise of being unshakable in the kingdom of God. All right, so question time. Just like every other week, I'm going to ask you guys a couple of questions. And again, I hope that you talk through it with your accountability partner and really work on the areas where you believe you need to grow in your personal life and your life with God. So question one, what armor do you put on to try to protect yourself? What armor do you put on to try to protect yourself? Question two, are you ready to surrender to God? Are you ready to surrender to God? Hey everybody, thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Weekly Words. I hope you thoroughly enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions for topics for me to talk about in the future, feel free to email me at weeklywordsrt@gmail.com. All right, I'll talk to you later. Have a great week.
Yeah. Stop me. Stop me.